we are, as so far, we understand that the urban is now a new phenomena. With the, in the last, I can say, 20, 25 years, the cities, they have come up, largely because of the economic development, liberalization, privatization, globalization, jobs creation, leading to migration. And a new phenomena that has come up in our country is urbanization. As far as when I say about Haryana, it is a very hustle-bustle state. We are encircling Delhi from the three sides, Gurgaon, Faridabad, Sonipat, to some extent, they are the engines of growth of this NCR region. And definitely it does poses the challenge. So far in the post-independence development of the country, we had largely been focused ourselves, and almost 80-90% of our administrative capacities in developing the rural infrastructure. But since with the economic development in the last 20-25 years, like I have explained, we are now diverting our resources, our whole of the administrative intellectual capabilities to manage these urban affairs. This urban phenomena has many components. One is housing. Like Madam has just mentioned, we earlier were grappling with the problem of roti, kapda and makan. Teen cheeze thi humare paas, roti, kapda and makan. With the green revolution of the 60s and 70s, we had been able to jump up the economic progress in the rural areas. So by and large, people, they have been able to ensure their roti and to some extent kapda also. And a significant percentage of people had been able to ensure the needs of their housing in their rural areas. But the migration from the rural to urban areas is now causing another problem of roti, kapda and makan in the urban areas. The economic progress has given that much of the money in the hands of the people, at least to ensure the roti and kapda to some extent. But housing is still a far-fetched dream for them. If I give an example of state of Haryana, Gurgaon is the place where maximum jobs are being created. To our understanding of the present times, that the first migration takes place because of the jobs. People, they migrate because I got a job in Gurgaon. Meri nokri lag gayi ji, mujhe jana hai. So, once they come up, their immediate need of the food and the amenities, they have been largely been able to ensure it. As the time passes on, the third need of the makan that comes up. And when it comes to the question of giving the houses to all, then it is a challenge. If I talk about my organization where I am currently working as a chief administrator, housing board, we were established in 1971. So in the last 30 to 40 years span, we have constructed around 1 lakh houses. But given the circumstances and current times, the 1 lakh houses is way too small number. And out of those 1 lakh houses, some over 75% we have been able to provide to BPL and the economically weaker section of society. Like I was talking earlier, that the migration takes place. Have you ever noticed who is the first one to migrate? One, either it is the lowest section of the society or the lower middle. Because the jobs in the masses, they will always be created by the private sector and with the lower wages. Mostly OBCs, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, BPL, economically weaker section. The whole gamut, when they migrate to Gurgaon or Faridabad or any other potential economically growing city, they make a new class that is called as the urban poor. These people, they have no place to go. Only the some of the experiments are being done with the land baseras and these temporary shelter places. So we have the, and it does poses the challenges. On the one side, it poses a challenge to provide them electricity, water supply, and they put a pressure on the urban infrastructure. From the housing perspective, what the challenges that we have been able to see and we are trying to find out the answers. Number one is capacity. There are multiple agencies like Housing Board. Then we have Haryana Shahri Vikas Pradhikaran, earlier it was called HUDA, and now the private players. These are the three predominant agencies working to provide the housing solution. But to some extent, I should admit it, that we have not been able to provide the solution which is both affordable as well as accessible. Again, who is the sufferer? These urban poor. Most of the land which is reserved for the construction of the houses for these so-called urban poor are generally far flung from the city because only the land is cheaper there. If I give you an average property prices in Gurgaon, it comes to be around 60,000 rupees per square yard. Average, that means if I am making a calculation of the far-flung area of Gurgaon and the most center of the city. So, 60,000 rupees prati gaj ke hisab se, agar 6 marle ke plot ki agar calculation karenge, to wo shayad uski 3 pidhiyan nikal jayenge, wo nahi le sakta. So, this is a challenge. Challenge is in the capacity of these organization to provide the houses. First is the availability. Kya ghar market mein hai? Now then there is another question that over the period of some time, these agencies, they have provided some housing. The question is comes the affordability. They don't have the money to buy it. Then this is a dynamic process. If suppose today I'm migrating from say district Jind of state to Gurgaon, okay fine, mere liye aaj migration ka pehla chapter ho gaya. Maybe next time I may get an opportunity, suppose in a Bangalore, then I have to dispose of my property. So the third challenge is of the real estate. In the present times, because we, as we all know, there is a general slump in the market, the transactions of the property is not happening. And this is now blocking the capital. Housing Board alone is having around 10,000 flats to be given to the people. But there is no buyer. How we can give it to them? It is the situation is similarly to the few years back we heard that the news used to come ki bahut sara gehun food supplies ke paas pada hai aur udhar bhukhmari hai. Why we just simply cannot give them free? At least somebody will eat it. If we have so many of the houses, can we simply allot it to them free of cost? At least somebody will live there. Maybe a very small fraction of the society will get some accessibility. Forget about the affordability. This is a question we need to really ponder upon. So far, we had not been able to find out the correct answer. Though there are the some financial incentive schemes like PMAY, we have the credit link subsidy scheme, and in the some other states also the state governments jumping in to provide the subsidy. So these are the issues we have to seriously consider as far as regarding the affordability is concerned. One is the another issue is the like I have just simply said the backlog I have already covered. So these are few of the challenges for the housing issue that we are grappling with. In this whole of the urban affair management, I would really request everyone to put up their intellectual, whatever the we say the intellectual capabilities to find out the solutions. Like one solution that we have recently tried is the e-auction. In the previous years, what we have experienced with the auctioning process is that, like if suppose I am a property dealer, I'll get the 10 urban poors and will fill up the forms in their name and get the flats.
Excuse me, Shaleen, I would have to request you to just expedite because we are supposed to close in 10 minutes.
Yeah, I'll just take 1 or 2 minutes, ma'am, nothing more than that. So, the last phenomena which I was talking about, a person fills up in the name of the 10 people for the future property appreciation. And that we say is the monopolizing tendency. The second question that we need to ponder upon is, can we consider a house as a commodity for the future appreciation as far as the section of this urban poor is concerned? So, these are the questions we had been working upon and we are working. In the recent past, I have just mentioned that we have launched the biggest auction of Haryana. 5,000 properties are on the e-auction. I'm sure to some extent it would be able to solve the problem. But still, there are the lakhs of the people without houses. We have to provide them a roof so the quality of life improves. As I have always say, and I hope in the next coming few years we will find out some solutions with the PMAY, CLSS, as well as giving the them at a subsidized prices through the auction. We have to imagine beyond our borders because imagination is the biggest form of courage. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot.